everyone.
Welcome to Level Rebel. This is Daryl. How's it, Daryl?
And yourself?
Lovely. Daryl is the owner of Cloud Performance here in
Kilsrubber.
Yeah. And this is his K24 Honda Accord. Currently one of the quickest Accords around in Cape Town with a Kilani quarter mile time of 13.1.
That's correct.
And what speed?
171 about, yeah.
Yo, that's impressive. Guys, so I was sitting passenger now on my way to our little shooting location. And this car is quick. Tell me a bit more about this engine. What power is it producing, I think, and how did you get there?
Well, basically, it's a stock sub, totally stock K24A sub. And we have the Type R head on there. Crowler stage 2 cams, valve train. And then we obviously have the on data going. Everything obviously motor built by myself, as well as tuned by myself. The gearbox is a special gearbox we have in here. Close ratios, stuff like that. We have a gearbox guy that does all our gearboxes, Anis Hassant, I think his surname is. He's got a four-wheel drive EK.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Yeah, he does all our gearbox work.
Oh, nice.
Obviously, you can't raise his prices now, seeing that I mentioned him on your channel.
So you said that kilowatt there was 213
at the moment, and 272 newton meters.
Yeah. So sorry about that. We had a bit of a technical issue there. I hope everything came out on the previous sections. In first gear, that's probably just in a spin. On the bounce.
Yeah, throttle is very sensitive.
Yo, very. The minute your foot starts jumping on the throttle,
I mean, you can adjust on the map on the car itself to make it a bit less sensitive. But yeah, I prefer driving the car like that.
So this engine, third gear, 3,000 RPM.
You can drift the car a bit more,
eh?
Yeah.
What's the rev limiter set at?
8.5.
Yo!
So,
tell me something. I think the biggest question I have here, I want to ask you, why Accord?
Well,
it's huge, it's heavy, it's not a good place to start.
That's exactly the reason why.
Is it?
Yeah. A lot of the guys obviously have the tendency to believe that Accords can't be made fast. And they had the same doubts about the EFIN 2 as well, because it's apparently the worst type of R.
Yes.
But I had the EFIN 2 as well, and I achieved a certain time in that, and I wanted to do exactly the same thing with the Accord.
So
that was the.
And you've accomplished it. Honestly, this car can go quicker than that 13.1.
It can, yes, definitely.
If you shave some weight out of this car, this engine is phenomenal, and you put this motor yourself together. You tuned it and everything yourself.
Everything myself. It's obviously the gearbox, like I said.
Yes, obviously. I don't like how EFIN 2 sound. They're very raspy and they're very loud. This has a lot of deepness to it.
Yeah.
And I don't know, almost an aggressiveness to it. And you actually lost power, right? You changed the exhaust.
I changed the exhaust because of Kalani regulations. I was afraid of obviously doing one run and being told that you can't do any more runs for this. So it used to be a 63mm 2-box system in the back. Now it's a 76x63 3-box system.
And you also, this is actually one of the cars that hold the records in Kalani for one of the most runs done.
That's reliable. I think it's 25 official runs for the day. And that's besides the practice runs and together the track dry.
And this is still that setup.
Nothing's changed on it.
K-series, not even a puff out of the back.
Back, that's totally.
Yo, K-series is not something.
This, like I said, the original motor, 256,000 Ks, you never want to believe.
Oh. Yo, K is unbelievable. Guys, so a lot of you who have Accords, and I know you guys are. But why tuning your cars? Because of that cost factor. Daryl, if I may ask, was this an expensive venture to do this
setup to the car?
This 13-second on the Accord?
what is your goal to the end of the day? Mm. That's what you have to do. My plan was to go fast, and I knew I was going to have to sprint to do that. Mm. So basically, valve train, cams, I mean, the KC response is expensive. They always say 1,000 rand for even a kilowatt or something like that on the K-series. So I think more or less, if I have to estimate it, obviously I spend less because I didn't have to do all the labor myself. Mm-hmm. I would say plus minus 60K maybe.
Oh.
Yes, with the gearbox, remember this is a special gearbox.
Yeah.
With the impact reality.
Yeah.
4.7 final drive. So and then obviously the gear ratios is totally different to the normal Eco gear ratios.
And I mean, you can pick these cars up on Gumtree for like 75, 95.
Yeah, no, you can get a decent one for about between 75 to 90, definitely. I always tell the guys with the EK, I don't know why they spend that amount of money on an EK when you can buy your Eco. Much better put together car.
Exactly.
Much better family car. And if you have to mod slightly on the Eco, I mean, Bruce does the flash for the Ecos. And then it's basically noise boy header, exhaust, induction. And the car will definitely make about close to 160 kilowatts. I mean, EKs were never going to make that power.
You're not. And you're sitting with such a nicer car.
Much better car.
Right. Let's see if we can drop it down a couple of gears. And I'm just worried for this road because you guys are the N1, isn't the nicest when it comes to speed traps and stuff. Fourth gear. We can rev it more, but we just want to check you under the bridge. This is a 120 zone, so. Many times was that street trim or you stripped out?
For the MSA event, it was stripped out with cheetah slicks front. The first time out with the car, we with the new setup, we basically, I think we managed the best time of 13.4, but we only got the car traction sorted out like late to the end of the day. And then I said, once we come again, we'll definitely improve on that time. The last Kalani event, I think, was the 27th. The very first two runs, 13.6, and after that, the time just dropped, and we ended up with a 13.1. And then, obviously, in this week pass, it was actually where you have to be full trim, you can't go with slicks. And we managed to do a 13.5 in full trim.
That is fast!
For a boat, they call this, eh?
Your personal opinion on this, what is the best beginner mods for this K24 is someone should go out and buy a Honda?
Either want to do minimal mods in the biggest gains, noise boy header, the cold air induction, they can go to Motorcade or they can come to Clown Performance because I also do the induction.
By you. I'll link his phone number and all his social media and in the description box below. You guys can go check him out.
And then obviously after that you need to do the flash from Bruce. He does the flash on the Ecos, and I mean, bang for buck, it lowers the VTEC point, increases the rev limiter, and I mean, for those basic mods, the car makes, I think, 143 stock. You'll probably end it up with just under 160 with those mods.
Exactly, and this lift comes in low, eh?
Mine, yeah, I see it low.
You get a shit? Let's put the engine under a bit more load. It should be able to hear.
Yeah, no, you will hear it. Yeah.
Here we go. So that actually helps a lot with your power band as well.
Yeah.
Just there's so much more power low down that you can actually make use of. I remember the automatic Accords, the executives have a pathetic, like, something like only have 1,000 RPM you in lift. 1,200.
But generally the Accords lift comes in quite late. I think it's something like after 5.5, and then it limits at 7.2. I mean, what do you do with that? So the flash on the cars, it actually brings it down, I think, to 4.8 or something like that, or to 4.6 actually. So your VTEC point comes in lower, which increases your power band just so much more. Obviously, the rev limiter is raised to 7.8, I think, on the flash as well.
This car's limiting 8,500
RPM. Yeah,
We still didn't get to push it yet because the road is full. But okay, we will get a gap now.
Yeah, 8.5. Bone stock sub assembly, 256,000 Ks, like almost 257.
Yeah.
The motor has not been, like, the pistons has not been taken out of this block.
Do you recommend the if someone maybe only finds a Honda Accord in automatic and the car's neat and stuff,
can they want to buy it?
Yeah, can the car make power with a gearbox?
Yeah, there is a few Accords that make power with a gearbox. But at the end of the day, it's do you really want to do that? You must decide at the end of the day.
Yeah.
If you want a car that's obviously you're going to drive every day, by all means do it, but you must realize it's not going to be as fast as the manual. And it's with the LSD. It's not cheap tires, it's got Richel Batins as well. So 18s, spins it like nothing.
This gearbox is stunning.
And he's brilliant with gearbox.
I need to get this man's details, I can send my boxes to him, my brother's car as well. Holy crap, this gearbox is on point. Even with the LSD, this car's like, ugh. This car's just having problems with traction,
yeah.
And I can kind of see why at Keelani you're not really moving that quickly out of the hole, because the car's still lighting the slicks up so much.
Yeah.
And I mean, I'm sure you guys saw on the video, I actually had a video on the MSA of his tires that he had on this car. It was huge!
Yeah.
I don't know this road too well.
Maybe you don't want to put it down, yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, it's
a 3
department.
Oh shit, okay.
Are they closed?
Oh,
no,
they're
open.
They're open.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go easy. Oh, this car, and another thing, this car is one of the nicest sounding Accords I've driven so far. This thing sounds fantastic.
Yeah, I have like a 6-inch stack on here at the bottom with a filter over it.
Sorry about that.
No, it's fine.
Okay, guys, now we maybe have a gap. So let's just look around us with anyone's sketch.
Yeah, put the traction control over there, we'll see. You'll see how the car really spins. Traction control is probably here, stopping from spinning.
Stopping it, yeah.
That's what I think. It's because look at the car, it's not so quickly.
Yeah!
So yeah. You didn't expect me to hear that.
Yeah! Guys, this thing is a monster, no? Straight across, no?
Yeah, straight. We go right up there.
Ah, oh, it's fantastic. Because I'm never gonna drive a car that feels like this again.
Think so?
Dude, this car feels stunning to drive.
Okay, we built a board, but we're building another FN2, also K24. Similar setup to this, but we're gonna do the bottom end probably and some extra stuff. So that car will definitely make more power than this one.
Yeah.
And then we'll get you the feature, then you can tell us again.
Yeah, no, definitely. I can't believe you made it be like this. Is this thing just
infinitely less healthy?
The LSD is so interesting. You're turning and you put your foot down, it pulls you towards the corner. I love that about the clowns though. Ladies and gentlemen, check out Clown Performance in Kuilsriver. Look, that's point blank. This is one of the nicest Honda Accords I've ever driven. And I think it puts you into perspective that these guys really know. Flipping hell. That just lights his wheels up.
Yeah, easy.
And these are 17s,
18s.
Yo, guys, check this man out. He's doing some stunning work with his cars and he's really getting the potential that these cars are supposed to have. I mean, this is stunning. This is stunning. 200 odd kilowatt.
I have to take my wife. without her, you know, she has to have the inner teeth. Because I mean, all the time that we have to spend in R&D, you know, right here, okay. R&D, and obviously riding around for ports and stuff like that. I mean, she hardly gets time to see me and stuff like that.
That's so sweet.
Like, yeah, and then obviously Team CP, Team Ground Performance. Slee Boy them, Rico them, and obviously Seat and Gary. There's a few guys. It's a funny story how it actually happened.
The clown performance.
Yeah, no, very funny story. We were giving our opinion on some mods and stuff like that, and because we tend to joke a lot.
Yeah.
And one of the other guys or our fellow tuners actually said you guys are a bunch of clowns.
Yeah.
And then Ziad said, okay, yeah, clown performance. And that name just fucking
sticks. That's fantastic.
And that name just fucking sticks.
Hey, yeah.
You know?
Honda is a cultural phenomenon in Cape Town. That's something similar to what the 325 IS is in South Africa.
Yeah.
I mean, these things are...
Or Superbus.
Yeah, Superbus even. It's just a cultural thing. I mean, yeah. All my comments is just filled with Honda K. It's unbelievable.
No, marvelous motors.
Yeah.
You can't, there's no motor, four-cylinder motor in South Africa. I don't think in the world they can compare to how restrictive this motor is from the factory, number one. And then with small breathing mods, this motors make so much power. I mean, a VVR will never be able to make that power from the... VVLs are a nice cars. I'm just putting the facts on the table.
Yeah.
Bolt-ons, intake, induction, branch, exhaust, and the tuning solution. This guy motors from the factory will make 170 kilowatts easily.
VVL can't do that. They peak here 155 with N1s and stuff. Actually, I'm lying. Yeah, they peak on standard stuff without opening the tappet cover. You can't get above like 170 on that motors.
Yeah, won't.
You can't. You need to fit cams in. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm glad to see the Honda Accord guys coming to the channel. Thank you so much again, Daryl. I really appreciate it. Because there's so much of them out there that's driving these vehicles. They want to know where they can go further with the cars because they think it's a grandpa's car.
Yeah.
And you can clearly see it's not. 13.1 seconds quarter mile is hugely respectable at that exit speed. So yeah, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe, share with your family. BFBU, love
the rebel.
Out.